Setting up high-speed inputs can often be intimidating, but with CLICK, it becomes just another simple function. This video shows how to set up a single input on a CLICK PLC for high-speed counting. To use high-speed inputs on CLICK, you must have a CLICK CPU that supports Ethernet and has DC inputs. High-speed counting is not supported on units that have AC inputs. You must have CLICK programming software version 2.3 or higher, and the firmware must match this software. I have an NPN inductive prox that meets the voltage requirements of the CLICK PLC. I'll wire the output of the sensor into X1, and since this is an NPN prox, I'll place positive 24 volts DC to the C1 common. To start the setup, select the function tab in the navigation pane. Select here on high-speed input setup. This display really makes a difference. It shows you exactly what each function does. Just check the graphic and then select the button that says use this mode. We're setting up counting, so select here. First, give this function a name, and then select the register where this total count will be stored. I'm going to use DD1. Now, this is a signed double integer, so the range of the address will be. To select single input, either choose up or down count. I'll use up count. We need to assign the input for this function. Select here, select X1. Now this will allow you to increment the count when the bit turns on, rising edge, or when it turns off, falling edge. Here are your reset options, and I'm going to assign the internal coil of C1. And when this bit turns on, it'll reset the count to 0. If you use an internal coil, realize the timing of the reset will be dependent upon the scan time of the CPU. The next option allows you to enable or disable the count based upon the status of this bit. You can also define a preset table here. This will turn on or off outputs or call an interrupt program when the count reaches certain values. Now, this is completely independent upon the scan time of the CPU and can be very useful in certain high-speed operations. For this video, I will forego this optional setup. So I will go back and accept all the setup, press OK, and now you'll see your single input function assigned here. Press OK, and now you'll see all the registers that are assigned to this function here. Let's load the project into our CPU and test the counts. Open up a data view, add my reset bit and my enable bit, and then my count. Enable the count by double-clicking here, and start the input pulses. It was just that simple. So no need to be intimidated by high-speed inputs anymore, just another way that CLICK makes advanced simple. If you have any questions, please feel free to comment below or call into our award-winning tech support team. Click here to see more videos on CLICK, and select here to subscribe to our YouTube channel to see upcoming products and solutions.